We use the computer to access the supervisory controller to see the system operation or to see how to use this supervisory controller. The computer and the controller is connected with the Ethernet cable. You can see the Ethernet cable connected here, and then this cable will connect to the computer. To access the supervisory controller, we need to know the IP address for this controller. The IP address it's come with the this controller. So we start from we use IE browser. On this page, it shows this page cannot be displayed. The internet protocol version is not set up yet. So we go to here. I click here, and then open the network and sharing center. And then here, you can click to set up the property of the internet protocol version. We select this one, double click this one. The internet protocol version 4, this is IPv4. We do this setting first for the IE Explorer. So we double click, and then we select use the following IP address. Here is 192, 168, 1, and then here you can put any number here, like 10, and then click here. This is a subnet mask. This is just default. Then OK. And then OK, and then close. And then again, then you come to this interface. This is the supervisory controller login interface.
Now let's log in the supervisory controller. We will use IE browser to access the supervisory controller. Before we start, we need to set up the IP address for the supervisory controller. So in your computer, click the network, open network and sharing center. And here, on the connection here, this connection is to the network, which is the local network, the system. So click it, and then we set up for the properties. Here, the IE browser is used the internet protocol version 4. So double click the IPv4. And here we use the following IP address. This address is for the supervisory controller. The IP address is 192.168.1, and the supervisory controller is 149, but we just set any other number. Let's just set up 10. Similar number, it's okay. So, and then we set up here. Click subnet mask. Here, this is the automatic. It's a 255.255.255.0. This is the IP address for the supervisory controller. So then we okay, and okay, and close. So the IP address for the IE browser is set up. You can also, we can use the Google Chrome, but the IE browser would be better. So now we start the IE browser. Then we enter the IP address. The IP address is 192.168.11.149. This is the supervisor controller IP address. This is the interface to log in the supervisor controller. On this page, you can log in to the supervisor controller as a administrator, an operator, a maintenance, and so on. Different roles. Different roles. Let's log in as an operator first. Operator, and then enter the password. And then log in. So this is the process to log in the supervisory controller.
This is the home page of the supervisory controller of FX system. On the home page, the left side here, you can see this is a navigation, the tree view, navigation tree view. And here in the middle here, that's the picture. This is could be the building to be controlled. The building to be controlled. Like here is the Centennial College library. And at the bottom here, this is the weather forecast. Weather forecaster, this is you can connect to the local weather service. They're here. And beside the picture, this is the main menu. The main menu so include the network device. A network device is the in the system. You can see here the navigation tree view. Here you see the device here. This is a backlit network and a Niagara network. The two type of device. This is the device manager. Drive manager. Drive manager is here for the device. Here there are two drivers, two systems. One is backlit network, the other one is Niagara network. You can see here the Niagara network is disabled because in this system we didn't use, we don't use it. We use the backnet network because the programmable controller is use a backnet network. Backnet protocol for the as the communication system. This is so we use backnet network under this. Under here, you can see the controllers is set up under the backnet network. Then we go back to the home page. You can go home page here. This is the home page, right? And the main menu here, the scheduling. Scheduling on the left side, this is the schedule manager here. And after that is a link manager. Link manager, you can see the navigation tree view. You can see link manager. And trend history. Trend history is for the some points. Some points need to draw the trend graph. Here's the trend history, which is the point history. Point history. And the summary information and system function here. List on the main menu. On the right side here, this the systems. These systems, it's many controllers in the system, in the whole system, there are many controllers. In our system, we just set up two controllers.
On top here, these are the some tools. The under the VAV box one, you can see the points. Here. These points, you can see, which is the input and output points. And this is the schedule, and trend log, and the configuration for this controller is the different points, like the input points and output points. Let's see the points here. Just double click the points here, and then you can see these are the points, inputs and outputs. When you guys build the program, you can see the points assignment. These are those points. Like this one, this is a zone temperature, and this is a damper position, and this is a discharge air velocity pressure, this is a supply air flow. supply air flow, and this is a occupancy schedule, and heating, and so on. These are all the points, and the column two. This is these are the description for the points. These are the value column. Three. These are the value of the controller of the points. This is a VAV box points values. Because the system is running, the system is working now. And the column here enables. Enable, which you can enable the points. Or you can disable the points. You just uncheck. You uncheck these points, and then it's disabled. And then you check it, and then it's enabled. The trend is the system built and chart for the points. How does it change? The system will build a chart to show to display the value change of these points, and the alarm you can check out of range depends the point, like the zone temperature. So if the room temperature is out of the range, then you will give alarm. So you select out of the change, out of the range, and then you will give alarm. The totalization is for the energy efficiency, energy saving. For some system, for example, they consume some power, some consume some energy, then this one can calculate the power or the energy consumed. For example, in the building, some equipment will consume some electrical energy. There is a power meter to monitor the energy use. So this totalization is calculate the power to be used. This is for the energy efficiency. So these are the points for the controller one, which is the VAV box one. The schedule here and the other controllers, the schedule here, they are sharing the same schedule, which later we will see the schedule manager. The trend, the system can build the change trend for the points. And here the configurations here. Configuration here is to see the points. It's what type of the points. Let's see. The configuration here, the configuration for the VAV box one. Here you can see different points here, and this is the values of the points. And you can check the points. For example, the zone temperature. The zone temperature, double click, and you can see the name here. The name here, and these points is the analog inputs. It's analog inputs, and here is the normal. And this is the damper position. Damper position is also a analog outputs. Analog outputs, and this is the heating. Like the heating output. Heating output, this is a binary output, which means turn on or turn off heating system. This is a supplemental heating source. And this is the lighting output. Lighting output is a binary output. This is a turn on or turn off the lighting in the zone. So here is the configuration for each point for the VAV box one. All these property is under VAV box one. Different control the points, the configuration of the points would be different. And now we continue to see the the Niagara network. This is not used in the system. Now let's see the schedule manager.
Double click Schedule Manager. Here, there are two schedules. These schedules are linked with the controllers or some points. Let's see here, these are the controllers we have in the system. The VAV box and lighting, they are sharing the same schedule, like the schedule 2 here. So let's see this schedule. Double click the schedule. Here is the schedule for the system controllers, VAV box and the PCG controller for lighting and the VAV box controller. Here you can see this is the 1 week schedule. 1 week schedule. The white color is the unoccupied. The green color here, it's the setting for each day, Monday to Friday, the building occupancy schedule. To set up the schedule, you just click the date. You see that, like you click this, the date you want to do schedule, and then you just drag it. Set up the time, start and finish. You just drag it. And or you can set up the time, like here you change the time, like 8 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock in the morning, and finish at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. You can set up the time here, and the status of the date is the time period you set is occupied, occupied. So this is to set up the date for set up each date the schedule in the building, and here is this. This page is set up for weekly schedule. It's set up for the weekly schedule. In some case, we will set up the special event. On this page, you set up the schedule is for every week. Every week. So this is a weekly schedule. If sometimes there is a special event, then you can go to special event here to set up the event for the date. To set up the special event, you just add. You can add here. And you start the special event, what this event is. For example, Centennial College has an open house on Sunday. Then we can set open house. Open house. And the date, this is you select the date, and it is usually the special the open house is on Sunday or Saturday. It's at the weekend. Then you can set Sunday, Suppose it's April 11th. You select the date here. You can select the date, like April 11th. This is the Sunday. It's Sunday. And then we set up here, it's 11 April. April 2021, and then it's okay. And this is add the special event to the calendar. Or if you you want to change the setup, and then you just delete it. And if you set up the date April 11, and then you can continue set up the time period in the date. So just click it and then you drag it. You click it and drag it, right? And then set up the time. Suppose the time is start from 10 o'clock, start from 10 o'clock and finish in the 3 o'clock in the afternoon. The building is occupied. So, and then you save. This date is set up for the schedule. Or you want to change something, then you can select the date, you can add it. Maybe the date is the Sunday is not April 11, it's April 12 that you change here. Now we see here the summary. Summary here, this is the overview. Summary. This is the summary of the building schedule. You can see the schedule here from Monday to Friday. Every day it's occupied. And this day is the special event. You can check the every day schedule. Like you click, and then you will see here these time periods. This is unoccupied, and this time period is the occupied, and after that it is unoccupied. You can check the everyday schedule from here. And let's see the property tag here. Property tag here is to do some setting for the schedule in the building. Like here, this is a default is unoccupied reset. Default is unoccupied. And here is the, let's see here. This is the configuration for the schedule. With two tags is occupied reset, and fourth text is unoccupied, because this is in the program we set the schedule. The schedule is occupied or unoccupied. Later we see the controller program. We check the controller we check the controller schedule. And here clean up special events. This is the true, just set to true. Now let's see the program in the controller. How's the occupancy. How's the occupancy of the building? Just start the PCT here, directly from here. This one will connect to the system, connect to the system in the computer. And you, if the computer install PCT, and then you can directly start from here. And here also will show you how to download the program from the controllers, like here. We download the program from a controller. Let's see. Now this time we use the lighting controller, which is a PCG controller. We select this controller and then start PCT. The select file cannot be found. We didn't connect to the controller yet. So now we download the program from the controller in the system. From the low here, this time the computer is connected to the system. No Bluetooth device connect to the controller now. Now we use the system, we use the supervisory controller to download the program from each controllers. So we select the backnet router. This one is from the supervisory controller. The supervisory controller, this is the address of the supervisory controller. This is the supervisory controller internal setting. The port is 80, and the network number is 2001. This is an internal. When we build the system, we configure the supervisory controller as the network 2001. So we just select, we input this number here. And here's a upload from the device, which is from the controller to the computer. This is upload the file from the controller. And here is a discovery. It's automatic reset. So next, now it's connecting to the controllers. Computer connecting with the controller. Now it's connected. Connected, you can see in the system here. In the system here, there are two controllers connect in this system. One's a VAV box, the other one is lighting, which is a PCG controller. You can see the controller here, PCV controller. 1832 and PCG controller 2611. This is the controller we have in the system. So we select the lighting this time. Select the lighting. We download the program from the PCG controller. So we select the lighting controller and then next. So here you can see display the information of the controller. Lighting is the name of the controller, and this is the model number of the controller. And then you can see here, this is the address of the controller. So now you can we can start to upload the program from the controller to my computer here. So continue. It's loading. moving the program from the controller to the computer. This is the program inside the PCG controller. Now we upload the program to the computer here. So you can see this program. Here is the occupancy schedule. We double click, you see what's here. This is the occupancy schedule. You can see here. The occupancy state. Occupancy schedule, the value is enumerate value. Enumerate value is the string, which is a string of the letters. So here, this is the number one is occupied, and number two is the unoccupied, and then standby and not set. The four situations for the occupancy schedule. So in the supervisory controller, the schedule should be matched with the text here, So in the program, the occupancy schedule, you can see the four situation here. So the on the schedule in the supervisory controller, the configuration for the supervisory controller should be unoccupied, occupied, and so on. So this is the properties of the schedule. The property of the schedule. Now we save. We save the setting. We finish here. And now we see how the schedule works with the system, in the system. Okay, let's see the controllers now. How does it work? This schedule is shared by lighting and by VAV box. VAV box. Let's show you the VAV box. This is the VAV box. This is a fully configuration. Now today, when I make this video, I'm making this video. It's Saturday. Saturday, the schedule is unoccupied, right? Like the schedule, we go back to the schedule manager here, because you can check the schedule on Saturday now. This is the schedule 2. We check the building schedule. Building schedule 2 here. You can see here. This is the Saturday. Saturday, it's unoccupied. Sunday is unoccupied. If it's unoccupied, you can see the VAV box. PV box here. This graphic will show you the VV box, the working state. Like here, the occupancy now is unoccupied. It's unoccupied because today, right now, is unoccupied in the building. Now if we go back, we set it to occupy, you see what will happen here. What we have here, and then we go to schedule here, schedule manager, double click the schedule, right now it's 150 something, 150. March 20. So we schedule. Now suppose we schedule on today. Schedule on today. You see what will happen on the graph. We just set up here. Set this one here. And then we suppose start from 12:30. 12:30 to 7:30, it's occupied. We set today, it's occupied. And then we see what will happen and save. And then we go back to see on the VV box graph. Here, VV box. See, now it's occupied. So the operator can change the building schedule. This is the schedule application here. Now let's continue to see. This is the schedule manager and then link manager. Link manager just some points, the points are linked to the different controllers. For example, the outdoor temperature sensor. This outdoor temperature sensor can be used for different controllers, so the system don't need to install many sensors to sense the outdoor temperature, right? So just install one outdoor temperature sensor, and then this signal can be linked to many different controllers. This is the link manager. The point group. In the system, there are many points. Like here. This is the global point extension manager. You can see global point extension manager here. Here is the total. All the points in the system. The first one is the VV box. VV box one. This controller. Many points. Many points here. And this part, the highlight, the yellow color. This is the lighting controller, which is a PCG controller. The points of the PCG controller. For the points, it's the same, like the column here. This is the device name, here's the points, a points name, this is device name, and this is the points name. And here's the value right now, the points value. And here's the, you can enable, you can disable the points. And here will this is the change for the points. For the system, they can, if you check these points at the change here, and then the system can draw the a chart for the points if the points value change, the change of the value. You can see the change of value. You can select it. You can select it. So the system can draw the change for these points. And here's the alarm. This is a totalization. And so this is the global points extension manager. So all of the points in the system will list on this page, on this here, on this manager here. The points group, just you select, you can select some points to group them. That's for better observation, better monitor the system. You can group some of the points. Like here, we just select a few points here. We select a few points here to group one group of the points for here to observe the system. And this is the global points extension manager. We just show you here. This one, it's the same with the controller points, like here. This is a global points extension manager here. It's the same with the points for each controller here. It's the same here. The difference here is the global points extension managers, all of the points in the system will be, you can see from this page, and on here you can see the points, some points of the operations, like here, these are it's purple, like this one, the VV box. This is a damper position. Damper position, you can see here, it's overridden. This is the operator set in 50% opening. This is overridden. If the damper position is set to auto, and this one will back to white color, and it's normal operation, If in some situation, the points will display highlight red color. If red color, that's it has the alarm, it will show the alarm. And then we see alarm console, alarm console here. Here's the alarm console. Alarm console here, you can see. You can select the time range from here, today or last 24 hours, whatever you select the time period, you can select it. And here under here, the colors, different colors here. The green color, which means it's normal. the yellow color here is acknowledged, and the red color is unacknowledged yet. So you can double click, you check the alarm for this item, and then you can check, and then you acknowledge, set to acknowledge, so you change to yellow. And also you can make some note for this alarm. What's the issue, what's the conclusion you have, and then you add to the notes here. Issue, let's say, suppose issue, and then a conclusion. And so on. And then you make the notes, and for the next shift, and then they can see what's happening. So that's the alarm console. Point history, you can see here the different points provide here in the system. Let's see how to draw the chart for the points. Let's see today or whatever last 24 hours. Let's see last 24 hours. We see the zone temperature. The zone temperature. How does the zone temperature change in the last 24 hours? okay. Let's see. Give a title. Temperature change in last 24 hours. So just select the points we draw. Just drag to this box. Drag to this box and then build. You can select the type of the chart. Select the type of the chart. I will select the line chart. So and then build. Now you can see the in the last 24 hours, the room temperature change curve. You can see. In the last 24 hours, the room temperature change. This is the temperature trend. You see the temperature in the room is changing all the time. And here is the administrator, administration. Here is the administration. On the home page, here, these are the main menu here, the network device. This one will connect to the different network station. And this one, the scheduling, here is the same, like the schedule manager we demonstrated already. And link manager is the same function with the link manager at the left side under the navigation. The trend history, is the point history on the left side under the navigation. And the summary information here is the points group. Points group is the same with the points group here. You can group some points for convenient to monitor the system operation. The function is the same with the points group here. And all the points summary is the same with the global points extension manager here. The alarm summary, this is the alarm console. The override summary here will show you some override in the system. Some points are overridden. For example, in the system VV box, the VV box here. If we set the damper position, we set the damper position to overridden, and then we'll see. If we set, this is the damper position. Here, now it's auto. You can set it to override. Let's say we just override like 50% opening. So there's a, now the damper it's moving from 100% open to 50% open. Now it's overridden. If so, on the home page, on the home page here, the override summary, you will see the points it's overridden right now. Now you can see the damper position here. This one, it's overridden here. Let's back to home page. This is the override summary and offline summary. If the point is offline, then the points are listed on the offline summary here. At the bottom, this is the system function. The backup, weather setup, and so on, for the, some user information. On the right side system here, these are the all the controllers in the system. If the system there are many controllers, they can list on the system here, and you can directly from here go to the controllers graphic. Let's go to the graphic. This is the VAV box graphic. VAV box graphic here. If the graphic is not shown, and then you can reload it. Just reload it. The graphics here. On this graphic, there's many information. This graphic can be fully configured. And here the occupancy. Now I just show and demonstrate original on. Today is Saturday when I'm making this video. it's Saturday. The building is unoccupied. Originally it's unoccupied. I modified and reset the schedule in the for the building. So now it's occupied. So here we'll show you the building, it's occupied. Right? And the damper position here, we just set it to overwrite. Set to overwrite, so it's a 50% opening now. We can set it back to auto. Set it back to auto. Now it will change back to 100% opening. Depends the signal the VAV box receive. So now it's a 100% automatic opened. And here, this is the room temperature. Room temperature. This is the temperature sensor in the from the thermostat. And here's the zone set point. Zone set point is 72 Fahrenheit degree. This is the from the thermostat. And on top here, this is the airflow. Airflow. And here's the cooling and heating system. If the system is enabled, it's green color. If the system is disabled, and then it will show the red color here. So in this VAV box, we only select the heating, which is a supplemental electrical heating. So the heating is enabled, so the it's green color. The cooling is disabled. This graphic can be add more components to the to here, and will and also it can be made automation. Automation, you can see the system operation. It's better show the system operation. Better show system operation. And on at the top here, there's some buttons. This button is the home. Home. Click here. Let's go back to the home page of the supervisory controller. And the other buttons here. These buttons, the function is the same with the left side, the function at the under the navigation. Like the points here is the same function with the points of the controller here, the points here. Extension is it's the same with the global points extension manager. Actually, these two are same because this is under the same VV box. They are the same. And totalization is for the energy saving. If some components consume the energy, and then can use this function to calculate the energy consumed. This is for the energy saving purpose. The alarm is the same with the alarm console. We'll show you the system alarm records here. The history is the same with the points history. Through this button, you can go to the points history to draw the graph for the points changing. So this is the VAV box system, VAV box controller. And the operator and administrator has different privileges. administrator has more privilege. Now let's log in as an administrator. Admin password. And then log in. This is the home page of administrator. It's not much difference with the operator and
home page.
Administrator can change their role from here. Like the site home. This is a site view of the home page. And this is a HX home page. HX home page is the administrator log in to the system. They use cell phone, use iPad, use pad, use a tablet to access the system. That's the HX homepage. Like the site homepage here. The administrator can change their role at the from here. This is the site home page. Let's go back to administrator home page. Administrator can modify the user profile in the system. Let's see the system here. Configuration. Go to the configuration here. System configuration here, there are some service. You can see some service here. The service here can modify the user profile. Here is the user service, under the user service here. This one here, this is a user type. User list listed here, like this is the administrator. This is the administrator. Administrator information would be here. This is the the password. This is the home page. This here is the home page. And the user details here, you can see the administrator, the details you can be filled out here, the address, the phone number, cell phone, and so on, all can be filled out here. And the administrator can modify the other user's profile, like the user type. Here, this is the administrator. Here is HX admin. This is the person who log in to the system from their cell phone, their pad, their tablet, and so on, under the permission here. And these are the HX admin. HX admin, this is the password. This is the interface. Interface of the, which is the home page of the system. And also the information can be filled out. Can be filled out here. Operator, we just introduced here the operator. Some operator you can add, more as an administrator. You can add more operator. and also the password setting, and the detailed information. And this is show the home page of the operator. And here is the maintenance, maintenance people. Also, their passwords, their maintenance interface. The different role has different privilege. And here is their information. And the Johnson control system provides five type, different type role for the building system. And the final one is the tenant, is the tenant. Usually the tenant is only can view some points, but they cannot do any change. Only some, like the thermostat, set points, they can do. Some public place in the building, even the tenants, they cannot do the setting. They can only do their home, their room, the temperature setting. So the Johnson control system, it provides five different type users, like the administrator, HX administrator, operator, maintenance, and tenants. Provides five different type roles, users in the system. Different user, their privilege is different. Let's see the user privilege here. For the service, you see the administrator to have all of the privilege, all of the privilege to read, to write, and initialization. Administration has all of the privilege. And the operator, you see some of the service is cannot accept, access, cannot access. As an administrator can modify the privilege for each role. For example, the category service in the system, like here, is the category service here. You can, as an administrator, you can modify the system different roles, this one. Like the operator, cannot do, so only the administrator can write an initialization, and the operator here, for the operation, for the category, here, you see you can uncheck it. So, I cannot modify and also cannot configure the category. So, you can save. Now, the operator, its limits, cannot access the category service. So now we can save the change. Can save the change. Or you can add. You can add the privilege to the operator. Here, can add. Just check it and modify. Configure it or add it, and then you can say okay, and then you can say so different roles. Different roles has different privilege. Different roles have different privilege. So in the system, to add the user to the system, we can go to the administration here, the user here, double click, this is the user manager. There are two users here. As an administrator, administrator can modify the users. To add the new users, and then we click new, and then the box will show you the user and how many to be at. We add one. And here we'll give you the username ABC, and the full name here is ABC XX. And what's the role for the new user? Can be administrator, I can be HX administrator, and operator, or maintenance, or tenant. Let's add as a HX admin, and then we set up the password for the person. Provides the person's email address, and also in this area provides the person's information like the address, the cell phone number or phone number, and so on. Fill out the form here, and then okay, a new user is added to the system. If you want to remove a user from the system, just select the person, and then just delete it from the system. This is about the user service. Under the administration, here this is the file. Under this file, there are many graphics, many graphics here. This is in the system library. You can open here to see. Like here, this is the heat exchanger. This is the heat exchanger, and this is the boiler, and some many graphics here in the system library. You can open it to see. You can see this is the graphic. This is a basic graphic, and then you can add to modify to configure the graphic. This is the graphics in the system library. under the administration, also there are some alarm service. There are different different service, alarm service, email service. These are history container view points extension default and user and user here. These are the system administration. As an operator, the privilege is smaller than the administrator. Let's go back to the service, configuration service here. Configuration service here, there's many other service. Like here, the job service and the alarm service, email service. Compare with the right side under the administration, here you can see the alarm service, email service, and so on. Yeah, and backup service. Let's see the alarm service first. They are the same. They are the same. And alarm service, oh no. Let me go back to this service. Go back to service here. And here, the alarm service. Alarm service, we can do some default setting. Here, default alarm. One is the type, transmission of the alarm. This is the off normal. This one you can select auto alert. And here is the those are default. Default here. Here is the default alarm console here. On the system alarm here, we can set up default like the time period, what time to what time, give the alarm and the date and the date here and the transition to off normal or to default to fault or to alarm. Here we can do some setting here. And another service is the email service. Let's see the email service here. The email recipient. The email recipient is also at the time, what time to what time receive the email, and the date from Monday, Sunday to Saturday, and also we can select as off normal or fault or normal or to alert. And here's the email sent to somebody, the address. This is the email service. And also the history service. History service is the point history, point trend. This one we mentioned already. And another one probably we need to use is the backup service. Backup service is a backup the system file to here. That's all for supervisory controller. How to access the supervisory controller, and how to use the function inside the supervisory controller as an administrator, operator, and so on. For the system, in some case, the system need to expand. In this case, we need to add some more we need to add some more controllers to the system. To add the controllers to the system, we need to program the controllers first, and then load the program to the controller, and then connect the controllers to the system, and then use the supervisory controller, configure the system database, add the controllers to the database. This is the all about the supervisory controller. Thank you.